society can stay healthy if fundamentally it neglects early learning, and everything else flows from that. The second question that comes from one of our texters, and probably the one that we'll close the conversation with so that we can continue with the program, is this. What is the single most important thing that a parent can do, in your view, to prepare their kids for kindergarten? If you had to pick, I know it's hard, but if you had to focus on a single most important thing, what leaps to mind for the three of you? Dimitri?
It's just about time. And I think that's the thing, that's the most precious commodity parents have, and I think it's the one that they are most guarded about sharing. So I hear from parents all the time, how am I supposed to make dinner for my child if I don't put them in front of the television? Not realizing that, in fact, there are many ways to make dinner with your baby. You set them on the floor. And their response is, well, I won't be engaged with my baby if I'm cooking. I can't really be engaged. Well, a six-month-old will get what she needs from you. I'm quite sure of that. And when I tell parents that you put your six-month-old on the kitchen floor, you give them a pot and let them cook with you, a light bulb goes off. And they actually have this realization that, well, maybe I actually could do that. Maybe I could multitask this to take a 21st century aphorism and spend that time. And those differences really add up. There have been studies that have shown just that, that if you look at kids that are kindergarten ready and kids that aren't, it isn't a single event, it's millions of little events. It's meaningful differences in the lives of everyday children, and it's very, very small things. It's the time that you spend with them while you're making dinner that actually makes a difference.
Charlie?
Well, this is, I'll take a, in the banking world, when we invest or lend on property, we talk about the three most important things, and that's the location, the location, the location. And in this case, I think I'd say read to them, read to them, and read to them.
Our librarians are enjoying that one. That's good. And Doreen, for you, single most important thing.
Read to them is very, very important. And I was just thinking, you know, with our parents, I usually say to them, they say it's so hard because I got to answer to all these case managers. I have to go to all these different places. By the time I get back to the shelter or wherever it is that they're going, they find that they're just so tired that they don't have time. However, I said, do you go shopping? And they said, yes. How about the laundromat? They said, yes. I said, because, you know, when I was a single parent, I remember with both my kids how difficult it was to still do homework and catch the bus and go grocery shopping. So the grocery store became school. We read the labels. They were able to tell me how much the difference was between canned good and get after me if I got something expensive, because they said, Mom, you're not looking at the prices. You know, I said, when did they get smart? So, you know, but the thing of it is, everyday things that you do, it doesn't have to be hard, because we have so many of our parents that are also English is a second language, and their big thing is they're afraid that they're going to teach their children wrong. We said, no. So what do you do? They sing to their children in their language. And I said, so what you could do is also have them sing it back to you in English, because they're in the school. You see what I'm saying? There's ways of how they can do it without thinking. They have to read from that book in English. Once they heard that, a lot more parents became more engaged at home with their children. Because what we do, we have a meeting after any of our assessments with the parent, as well as the case manager and the teacher, and we're looking at, how can we help this child together? So you make it a mini village when you have that type of situation. It can't always be alone. But as a single parent, when my children, and of course now the kids, I have to give credit to the father too, because he had a lot to do with what happened with them. I'm so proud to say that both of them finished college. They went on and went through the public school system. And I truly believe it wasn't just me or my husband. It is the environment. It's what you take them to, expose them to. And one more thing real quick. I'm a grandparent, and I have a lot of buddies in here who might not want to share, but you're grandparents too. And as a grandparent, I notice my two grandkids, they're 2 years old and 4, and they like to emulate what I do. So I always pick up my briefcase or what have you. And they've gotten in the habit, you know, I'm an absent-minded person nowadays. So when I get ready to leave the house, my granddaughter, copying me, picks up her briefcase, she comes to the door, and my grandson will check to make sure I have everything I came into the house with. Grandma, you got your keys? What about your shoes? You got? Because they know I will come back getting something. So really, all of us being aware that our children watch everything we do, even when they're not able to speak to us.
Well, Doreen, you know, first of all, can I borrow your grandchildren? the other thing that Doreen's comment reminds us of, and as we close this conversation, is also that for all the emphasis we place during conversations about early learning, about us as the educators, is remembering at every moment that our children are the teachers too. Yeah. That they are teaching us at every moment. And sometimes what they're teaching us is how to teach them. But we have to pay attention for that. And you know, my daughter is now 10, and it seems just a few minutes ago that I was worrying about her early learning. And as I think about the foundation for early learning now itself being 10, one of the things that we have to remember to do, that this foundation as an organization needs to remember, and that everybody in this room has to remember, is that we have to go to each other, to the people we work with and the people we serve, and ask them continuously, please, teach us how to teach you.
Right.
Show us how to show you why this matters, and engage in that kind of lifelong learning, as Charlie says, about ways that we can tell the story about the centrality of early learning so that 10 years hence, when we're here for the 20th, it's a no-brainer, and everybody gets it, and we're celebrating what we helped create today. Thank you all so much. Thank you to our panelists, Doreen, Dimitri, and Charlie, and I'll throw it back here. Thank you very much.
We also have set up a website, and these three panelists will be able to address your questions when you go home if you weren't a texter. And the website is going to be www.earlylearningcommunity.org. Earlylearningcommunity.org. And the three of them, or you could address the question to Dimitri or Doreen or Charlie, whoever you'd like. Thank you so much. That was terrific, Eric. I didn't know you ahead of time, but they said I'd not to worry. You'd do a great job, and you did. Thank you.
Yes, and thank you. Yes, we are 21st century. And you can also find us on Facebook and Twitter, so be sure to look for us. You know, we all are building a foundation for early learning for young children, parents, and communities. We want all children healthy and ready for school. And as Senator Slade Gordon said in 2004, we now know that early learning is not a luxury, it is a necessity. I invite you to contact me or the foundation staff or our board. And I want to especially thank my team members. Thank you, foundation staff. Thank you so much. So we're just about at 1:30, and I also want to invite you to attend the salon that we're hosting. It's going to be off on the left-hand side in the Fifth Avenue room. It is going to be hosted, or excuse me, it will be featuring Dr. Betty Hyde of Washington State Department of Early Learning and Nina Auerbach, President and CEO of Thrive by Five Washington. I'm looking, I know I saw Nina earlier. Oh, hello, Nina. So please join us. You have a few minutes to network, and then we'll be in the salon from 1:45 until 2:30. Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much, and I really appreciate your support. Thank you.